Welcome back. It is 6:54.
We want to get you ready with these top stories as you head out the door. State COVID update. State Health Officer Dr. Scott Harris will give an update on the state's efforts at 10 this morning. We'll have the very latest for you online at waytv.com and on the Way 31 Midday News.
Albertville City Schools now requiring students to wear a mask. It comes just 4 days after the school made masks optional. The district will reevaluate the mask policy in 3 weeks.
State Board of Education meeting. The agenda says the board plans to announce intent to amend an Alabama administrative code rule pertaining to certain teaching techniques. That specific rule pertains to the teaching of yoga in schools.
Search for a kidnapping suspect. Officers say Armando Morales assaulted one woman before taking her 11-month-old child. The baby was found safe. If you have any information on Morales, contact the DeKalb County Sheriff's Office.
Homicide suspect behind bars. The Rainsville Police Department say Jason Cardwell is charged with the murder of Ricky Wilkes. Cardwell is now in the DeKalb County Jail on a $1 million bond.
Food City hiring a vent. It starts at 4 and ends at 8. You can apply on the company's website or just walk in and fill out an application. Food City says it's looking to fill full and part-time positions. There will also be a hiring event on Saturday.
The final day of the Space and Missile Defense Symposium. It's at the Von Braun Center. All attendees are required to wear a mask because of the recent surge in COVID cases.
And a traffic alert starting at 9. Limestone County crews will close Nick Davis Road at the bridge over Piney Creek. That's in Athens, right off I-65. It's happening today and tomorrow. The area will be closed until 2 on both days.
Water outage in Marshall County. Water will be out from Anderson Ridge Road to the top of Simpson Point Road starting at 8 this morning. That's in between New Hope and Grant, just north of Gunnersville.
And some good news, again, that heat advisory canceled for today. Still going to be hot and humid. Still expecting those heat index values up to 100, but a little bit lower than what we've seen the last couple of days. Actual temperatures up to around 90 this afternoon. A few pop-up showers and storms, but the coverage will be much lower than what we saw yesterday, I promise you. And a beautiful view around North Alabama right now. You'll actually notice the changes this morning. We're in the low 70s right now. That's nearly 10 degrees cooler for some areas. And we're also seeing slightly less humidity. But we'll continue to see the daily thunderstorm chances along with the heat and humidity into this weekend. And also watching Fred closely.
All right, keeping the umbrella handy. Thank you, Rob, for 24/7 coverage you can count on. Head over to waytv.com.
The news continues with Good Morning America. We'll see you back for a local news update right here at 7:23. Have a good morning.